Steve Dotto here. Thanks for joining me today. A little bit different today in the fact that I'm not in my home studio. I'm on the road, actually. I had a speaking engagement in beautiful Kelowna, British Columbia. But I realized I hadn't done this week's video, and so I am having to kind of make do and ad lib and do it on the road. So I've got my trusty iPhone headset and a Logitech webcam, and I'm ready to rock. I think we'll be okay. Today's topic is preparing for the holidays, is getting all of the families together for things like Christmas dinner, Boxing Day, gift exchanges, that sort of stuff. So there's a whole variety of different tools that help make that a little bit more efficient. And it's an important factor because today we have blended families and we've got, trying to get your group of people together for Yuletide festivities can be a bit of a challenge. So I've got four different ways that I'm going to blast through really quickly to show you how you can better organize your clan for Christmas or holiday festivities. So the first is the classic Evite. We've all received Evite invitations and they work great. If you haven't set one out yet and you haven't used one, they've got probably the most visually appealing all of the different invites. They've got lots of different tools that allow you to create really nice feature-rich invitations that you send out to people. And the bottom line with all of these is we use email to send out invitations to people. They can register. You don't have to deal with RSVPs and ticking people off lists. People tick themselves off lists. And if you have other special requests for them, like the number of people that they're going to be bringing or asking them to bring along some hors d'oeuvres or something, you can enable that all within this kind of an environment. So the Evite system, clean and easy to use. You create an event. You give it a date, a time, who the host is. You fill in the information. You can add a little bit of information in this message from the host area. You can fill out some extra information about what's going on this particular, if you got a theme or something like that. And then over on the right-hand side here, you've got the ability to have different styles of RSVP telling who's coming. What's important here is notifications letting you know when people RSVP. But the one that's kind of sensitive is if you want to hide the guest list or not. Again, with today's blended families, sometimes you don't necessarily want to have the same people at the same event, or certain people at the same event, so you might want to hide the list if you want to be a little bit, add a little bit of subterfuge to the whole thing. So that allows you to do that as well. And then finally, different guest options, allowing how many people they can bring, if you're going to limit the total number of people that are coming, etc. Once you do this, you continue on through, and then you incorporate an email list, and you send it off to your friends and family, and it works really well. Now, along the same lines, less graphically appealing, but a little more interactive, is a tool that I like called SignUpGenius. Now, SignUpGenius I like for a variety of different things, but basically it allows you to create lists to allow people to sign up, and it's not limited to holidays or parties. Teachers can use it for setting up sign-up forms for their students. You can use it for a softball team sign-up. You can use it for all sorts of different things. And they've got a free all the way through to paid versions of SignUpGenius. But here's what I like. If you take a look in their pre-baked templates, they've got these potluck party organizers, which are great. And I've used this myself for Christmas, where we've had a whole group of people coming together. Because we're so busy, I didn't have time to cook all Christmas dinner myself. So I actually set up within SignUpGenius an order form where I invited people. I said, you got to bring something from the list, or please bring something from the list. And I was able to articulate exactly what I wanted from my menu. So I was able to say, I want mashed potatoes. We don't want baked potatoes. Who wants to bring the mashed potatoes? Who wants to bring the vegetables? No Brussels sprouts, please. And I'm able to kind of articulate exactly what I want. People are able to choose what they want to bring from the list. And then as the host, you can check the list a week before or a few days before the event, see what's missing, and then determine what you have to make yourself. Worked great. SignUpGenius is a really powerful tool that I like a lot. And as I say, it's not just for holiday time. You can use it year round for, I've seen businesses use it for vaccination, for, flu shot sign-up forms, to be able to create those sorts of forms for people to be able to sign up to get their inoculations. It's a really cool tool from that perspective. Now, before we leave the holiday theme, even though it's not about necessarily organizing people at the event for the time of the event, SecretSanta.com allows you to create those Secret Santa events that a lot of families do, especially the adults in a lot of families. So you have, instead of having to buy everybody gifts and to make sure that everybody does get a gift, you have a Secret Santa exchange where everybody gets connected to one other person. And with this list, this is the one that my family uses, actually. People can go in and they can actually edit and put into the list all of the different things that they're interested in, so you make sure that you get the right size or the right color or the right thing, mainly for adults, so that we can make sure that that you get a gift that you appreciate come holiday time in your particular family. And also, I'm avoiding the politically incorrect Christmas, although we know we're talking about Christmas, don't we? And finally, Doodle. I love Doodle. Doodle is a great invitation manager. Now, where Doodle really works well at Christmas time, though, is figuring out what the best date for everybody is. So with Doodle, we actually create a poll, and I'm going to have a link right down here to another demo that I have of Doodle, which kind of walks you through how it works. But the Doodle polling, the Doodle poll system here, allows us to create a date. You schedule an event where you create a new poll, and you send it out. So at Christmas time, what you can do is you can tell your family, okay, who's available Boxing Day? Who's available Christmas afternoon? Who's available Christmas Eve? And you can put in three different times if you're thinking of having three different times to try and get your family together. Send that out and see what the majority rules. See when the majority of people are available to come over, and then make that the time. Rather than all of those emails going back and forth to try and determine an exact time for an event, Doodle really works well to kind of shortcut all of that for the poor organizer that's trying to pull all these different parts of their family together. So not much on the demo side, just four different websites that you can look at that will help you a lot come Christmas time. Got Evite for sending out straightforward invitations that look great. You've got SignUpGenius for allowing people to sign up and help for things like potluck dinners and that sort of stuff to bring everybody together and make sure that they all pay their own way by bringing something along. You've got Secret Santa to make sure everybody gets exactly what they want at Christmas. And you've got Doodle to allow you to organize to make sure that the majority of you can get together and celebrate and enjoy each other's company come holiday time in your household. I hope you found this video useful. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.